So I'm in New York. I want to buy something. It's on the website. I get it. Why does it not get to me within the amount of time I'm used to getting it by?
Sure. Well, at the moment, whatever you ordered is probably sitting in a shipping container that's stuck on one of the several dozen ships, as many as 60 or 70 ships that are anchored off the coast of Southern California, just waiting for a spot at the dock to come in and unload. But this has been going on since the start of the pandemic, you know, from the factories in Southeast Asia through the ports on the west coast of this country to the trucking firms, the rail yards, right up to your doorstep. There have been problems one after the other.
And each one feeds the other, right? So explain what happened. So as you said, there are all these ships waiting there. They can't get a spot. But now the trucks that have been waiting for my, you know, for the ship containing my goods is now off schedule, right?
Exactly. This system, you know, it sounds on the one hand, the supply chain, like the simplest idea. We're really just talking about moving boxes from point A to point B. But in practice, it turns out to be devilishly complex. And the system works quite well under normal circumstances. And it's built to operate a little bit like runners in a relay race. I run my lap, I hand the baton to you, you run a lap, and so on. But if when I finish my lap, you're not there waiting to take the baton, it doesn't matter how fast the next guy is, the system grinds to a halt. And that's what we're seeing with the supply chain. Those ships can't get to the docks. When they do, it's terribly crowded. The trucks that normally get in and out in the blink of an eye take forever. And the same thing happens at the rail yards, and the breakdown feeds on itself.
Is there a kind of original cause to this, what's going on right now? Or is it just so complicated one can't even pinpoint a place where it all started?
Well, the original sin is really the change in consumption patterns that occurred as a result of the pandemic. You go back to last year when many of us were trapped at home for a long time. We all stopped going out and spending money on services, at restaurants, ballparks, movie theaters, concerts. And we all, many of us, started ordering more stuff on Amazon, Walmart, and elsewhere, laptops, furniture, clothes, what have you. And so if you look at the nature of the economy, services always dominates the U.S. economy, makes up about 70% of spending. But the goods side of things, goods spending went down for about 4 months, surged right back up, and now exceeds pre-pandemic levels. Services spending is still way down. So the nature of what we're buying has changed. And we've got a supply chain that's set up for an economy that no longer exists. We're in a new world.